She's not an athlete or a superstar, so why is everyone asking a local woman for her autograph? Because she is about to be seen in homes across America, and she's as surprised about it as anyone. Just imagine strolling down your favorite grocery aisle when all of a sudden you realize that your face is all over some boxes of cereal. That's about to happen for one woman here in Smithville.
Kathy Dibben never considered herself a hero or a role model. So when she got word she was about to have her face plastered in supermarkets from coast to coast.
The first thing that went through my mind when I got the initial email was this is some kind of hoax.
It's no hoax. General Mills discovered Kathy on a website blog where she told her story, a two-time breast cancer survivor who now devotes her life to this little boutique in Smithville, specializing in products for cancer patients. In honor of breast cancer awareness in October, Kathy will be featured on 20 million boxes of Cheerios, with some of the proceeds going to fight breast cancer.
Well, it's all kind of surreal. I was excited to be able to be part of this campaign because that just allows me to reach more women, and that's what my goal is right now, is to let more women know and to worry, you know, to work with breast cancer awareness. That's what this store is about.
Kathy says she carries products she struggled to find, like a mastectomy swimsuit. She sells wigs and fashionable headwear for those going through chemotherapy. But she tries to offer more than merchandise. She offers hope, and she has a grand platform to do it on millions of breakfast tables across America.
The common phrase right now is, will you sign my box of Cheerios when they come out? So we're looking forward to that too.
Now, Kathy's shop is called Absolute Dignity. It's on the square in Smithville. This is the second year General Mills is featuring breast cancer survivors on its Cheerios boxes. And for more on Kathy's story, you can go to our website, KMBC.com. We'll give you a heads up when those cereal boxes hit the store shelf.